What's up, everybody? Welcome back. In today's video, we're gonna continue cleaning up the back of this go-kart. We got everything cleaned up front. We're gonna be moving to the back now. All these additional tabs, all that's gonna be coming off. And we're gonna try to cut down this frame and get the dimensions of it so that it'll fit into that Mustang. And then we'll be able to start trimming the plastic on the Mustang. No point in wasting any time. The first thing we're gonna be removing are these seat brackets, and we'll just start slowly working our way to the back. Those brackets were welded in a lot of places I just didn't have access to. They are off, I'll get them cleaned up. Unfortunately, they're destroyed, so hopefully we won't be needing them. I don't think we will. And then we also got this crazy monstrosity of a weld over here. The bigger the gob, the better the job, I guess. But the frame must have cracked and they just kind of gobbed a ton of weld in there. So we'll get that all cleaned up and see what's underneath it. Everything on the back of this cart has been taken off that I wanted to take off. Still gotta clean it up. But I have these brake caliper brackets, and they're these complicated pieces that wrap around. One down, one to go. That's where I'm gonna be leaving off this video for the night. We got our brackets all taken care of. Everything's cut off in the back. So tomorrow we're gonna be putting this body onto this frame, and then we'll be able to cut it and hopefully shrink it down to the exact dimensions we need. What is up, guys? It is the very next day. So we're gonna be cutting this go-kart. I'm gonna show you exactly where I'm gonna be making my cuts. They're all gonna be on nice straight pieces. I don't wanna make any cuts on bends because that's gonna make it significantly harder to weld. When I do make my cuts, I'm gonna plan on joining the two pieces back together with a little sleeve that's gonna go on the inside of the tube. Nice straight cuts will make that significantly easier. So I think I'm gonna be cutting it back here on this nice straight line. We'll be cutting it up here. And once that back half is completely detached, we'll be cutting it right down the middle. And that'll let us shrink these two tires in closer together to fit the wheelbase of that power wheel. So I threw an extra sawhorse in here just to keep the front of this thing from falling on the ground when I cut it. I'm gonna go ahead and remove the back half of this frame. There's not a whole lot left to this poor thing. I did get the frame cleaned up here, and I cleaned up that little notch, and then I also got this back on the ground, and I threw some shims underneath here, and that's just gonna help keep these tires nice and straight. I'm gonna put the body on top of it. I'm gonna grab some measurements, and then that way I'll know exactly how much I'm gonna be taking off of this frame and shrinking it. We can see just how much of that tire is actually sticking out. It's basically the entire thing. I'm going for looks on this, so I'm gonna be cutting that down and trying to tuck those in a little bit more. It's gonna make it a little more rolly, but that's fine with me. So here's what I'm working with. I got 3 inches from the widest part of the fender to the outside of the front tire. Then in the back, I got 4 inches from the widest part of the fender to the outside of the tire. I gotta keep in mind that when I'm building this thing, the wider I keep these tires, the more room I have on the inside for the motor, engine, axle, seat, all that stuff, because that still has to go in there. I think this is what I'm gonna be rolling with. So now I'll go over here, I'll take my measurement, and however much I need to take off to get this side to equal that side, the 3 inches, that's what I'm gonna cut out of the center of that frame. According to my calculations, we're gonna be removing 3.5 inches. I'm gonna be taking measurements from this point here to this point here. That'll give me a good baseline, so when I remove that 3.5 inches, I'll be able to remeasure, subtract 3.5, and I'll be able to get that exact. I'm gonna do the same thing in the back, and that'll keep everything nice and square.